Hello everyone, this is Vidisha and today I am going to talk about ribose switches. Here we will see how RNA molecule can regulate bacterial gene expression. So a separate RNA molecule may bind to the mRNA in trans and affect its activity. Like here I am showing there is a mRNA whose ribosome binding site is located here. Now a small RNA can come and bind to this ribosome binding site, leads to affect its gene expression. This effect of another small RNA to the other mRNA molecule is called as intrans effect. Again, when a part of a molecule affects the function of another part of the same molecule is called as cis effect. How? I am showing you here an mRNA structure which has ribosome binding site. As you can see, upon binding to a ligand, because of this tertiary structure formation, the ribosome binding site is blocked now and the translation got affected. So, a portion of a mRNA molecule is affecting its own gene expression. That is why it is called as cis effect. Ribose switch is a gene regulation mechanism mediated by RNA in bacteria. It is a sequence of RNA mostly found in the 5' untranslated region of bacterial mRNA. It folds into a complex tertiary structure known as aptamers. As I already mentioned, this is an example of cis-acting regulatory elements. That means ribose switches regulates its own mRNA expression. And these ribose switches are responsible for 2-3% of gene expression control in bacteria. And they are also found in archaea, fungi and plants. Now, as I mentioned, aptamers are the complex tertiary structures. They can bind to a small molecule metabolites which when present in very high amount. And these small molecule metabolites can be a metal ion, a nucleic acid precursor like purine, amino acid residue like lysine, and also enzyme cofactors like FMN or S-adenosylmethionine. This interaction of small molecule metabolites with aptamers can occur through non-covalent interactions like electrostatic interaction, hydrophobic interaction, and also induced fitting interactions. There are two domains of ribose switches, aptamer domain and expression platform. As you can see, in the aptamer domain, ligand binds. So when aptamer binding leads to the change in the conformation of expression platform, thus change in the gene expression happens. There are two modes of action of ribose switches. One is premature termination or transcription attenuation, and the another is translation inhibition. As you can see in this image, there is an anti-terminator loop present here. Because of this, there is no problem in transcription. Transcription can continue. But upon ligand binding to the adapter region, a termination loop will happen, which is followed by uridine residues. Thus, transcription will be stopped. And you can see in this picture that there is a ribosome binding site in the mRNA, which is easily accessible by a ribosome for the translation to happen. But when a ligand will come and bind to this aptamer region, the ribosome binding site is blocked. Now there is an inhibition in translation. So these are the two ways a ribosome can work. Let us see an example in bacteria Bacillus subtilis, where ribosome control of transcription termination will see where an operon, which is XPTPBUX, operon which encodes enzyme for purine synthesis. Here you can see this DNA is bound by RNA polymerase, from where the transcription is happening, and a 5' UTR region which has formed a tertiary structure like this. Now let's see what happens when the metabolite purine concentration is low and when purine concentration is high. In low purine concentration, you see there is a formation of loop structure and tertiary structures are there, but the terminator loop structure has not formed in this case. So the gene is on and the transcription continues. But in case of high purine concentration, the purine molecule bind to the aptamer region, which leads to the formation of a terminator stem loop structure. As you can see here, the purple and the sky blue stem loop structure, which was not a terminator loop, but in this case this sky blue hairpin formation and the small terminator loop formation leads to the transcription inhibition. Here I am showing you a crystal structure of a ribosome, where you can see a purine molecule is binding to the tertiary structure. Now we'll see how a metabolite can regulate gene expression in multiple ways. Here the metabolite we are considering is thiamine pyrophosphate. Now when thiamine pyrophosphate bind to the aptamer region, as you can see there is a formation of terminator loop which is blocking the transcription. Also this can form a loop stem loop structure with the ribosome binding site, hence it may lead to block translation. Also it sometimes leads to the intron splicing inhibition by preventing the close coming of these two sites, which is 3' splice site and 5' splice site. We will now see the regulation of bacterial mRNA function in trans by small RNA. So small RNAs like DSRA, RPRA and OxyS are involved in the regulation of RPOS gene, which codes for RNA polymerase sigma S. Now there is a chaperone protein which is HFQ. It has a toroid structure with a pore in the center. This facilitates RNA-RNA pairing. Now if you look at this image, DSRA is a small RNA which along with this chaperone protein paired with the RPOS mRNA, which otherwise was forming a stem loop structure and blocking the ribosome binding site. Thus the pairing of DSRA small RNA with this RPOS mRNA leads to the opening of ribosome binding site, hence translation is on in this case. The next small RNA, which is OxyS, when this along with the chaperone protein binds to the ribosome binding site, that means this small RNA is doing base pair with the ribosome binding site, hence the translation is off. These are the ways how a small RNA can regulate bacterial gene expression. This effect is called as intrans effect. These are some suggested readings. Thank you for watching this.